Hi, I'm Mike Corbett, CEO of Citigroup, the world's global bank. I'm speaking to you from our world headquarters in New York, overlooking the Hudson River and New York Harbor, about 2 miles north of Wall Street. About 200 years ago, a group of local merchants founded our firm to finance the flow of furs and other commodities from the Republic in exchange for manufactured goods from Europe. Since then, Citi has grown into one of the world's leading financial institutions by financing the free flow of goods and critical infrastructure that's fueled this city and our country's growth. It's clear that there's one common thread that ties the evolution of our company, the city of New York, and our country, and that's trade. Trade is what stitches people together and allows communities to prosper. Banks were originally established to provide safe storage for money. But instead of just safeguarding this money, banks began lending it to help clients who needed help funding their ventures, adventures, and in some cases, misadventures. And when we flash forward to today, we at Citi are still doing much of the same. We protect people's savings and lend deposits to help people buy what they need and what they want. In addition to our traditional banking business, we provide advice to individuals on how to invest for their future, whether that's savings for their kids' education or for their own retirement. We also serve companies, both big and small, across a multitude of needs. We help them meet their payroll, manage their cash, finance their supply chain, and exchange currencies, just to name a few. With our help, companies are able to create jobs, to build factories, and allow people, families, and communities to prosper. And we don't just help clients here in New York, but around the world. Citi does business in more than 160 countries and jurisdictions, and in some cases, our presence dates back more than a century. Every day, we help companies compete on the world stage and sell their products in markets around the globe. But we also know we need to strike a balance. In an economy where farming and manufacturing as a proportion of total economic activity are in decline and services are rapidly ascendant, the skills necessary for the workplace are being redefined. Citi is doing our part to ensure young people are ready. A few years ago, the Citi Foundation launched an innovative program called Pathways to Progress. When we looked at the root cause of youth unemployment, we saw a clear disconnect between the skills young people have and the ones they need to launch a career in the new economy. A program that started out helping 100,000 young people in 10 U.S. cities went global last year. Now our target is to touch 500,000 at-risk youth worldwide by 2020. We're hoping to help close the skills gap and the life gap too many kids face between their current reality and their true potential. One thing we and our critics agree on is that what happens on Wall Street has a huge impact on Main Street. Citi has an established mission of enabling growth and economic progress around the world. And you can be sure helping people, businesses, and our communities is at the core of our mission. Over the past 10 months, you've heard from some of the world's financial leaders as they've explained why Wall Street matters. I've enjoyed sharing with you why Wall Street matters to us at Citi in the final segment of the CEO series, a collaboration between the Museum of American Finance and Cheddar Media. Thank you.